actually spun the tires. Hi, people of the interwebs. I have a question. Do you aspire to live in a van down by the river? Well, if you do, then good. If not, you're gonna want to by the end of this video. Today, I have a special vehicle review for you. It is a 2020 Mercedes Metris cargo van. Typically, when you see a cargo van, they're usually white or beige or some kind of boring, ugly color, but not this one. It's done in juniper red, which is super pretty in person. It's actually got a little bit of a darker tone to it. And yes, the bumper covers are raw black plastic, but it is an option from the factory. You can get them color matched, which I would highly recommend. These are the base model halogen headlights, but there's tons of options you can add to these vans from the factory, one of which being a premium light option. These 20 spoke 17 by 7 inch wheels are optional, but they're only $400 of an add-on for a set of wheels. That's cheap. Let alone for being an accessory on a Mercedes. I think it's kind of a no-brainer. You'd have to get these. And I'm a fan of straight multi-spoke wheels like this on European cars. It looks fire. Hello. Welcome to the slidey boy on the side of the Metris 135. 135 because this is the 135-inch wheelbase version, which means it's longer than the 126-inch wheelbase version, which is a difference of 9 inches in case you don't understand numbers. You can also get a sliding door on the other side of the van, and you can choose windows if you like. I prefer it with no windows, slick on the side, just good looking like that, and gives you privacy. Bye. Not only do you have different lengths in the van that you can choose from, but you have three different ways you can get the back door. You can get a lift hatch or either 100 or 270 degree swinging doors. A cargo van wouldn't be complete without a van lifer enjoying a good book in a cozy sleeping bag with a iced chai latte. You have a good day. Hands down, the strangest fuel filler door I've ever seen on a vehicle. You open the driver's side door and it's right here. That is so weird. The Metris van is equipped with a roof. It makes different sounds depending on where you tap on it. Then it also has roof rails. The Metris van has a feature I've never even heard of on a vehicle before, but when you press the unlock button, it actually turns on the fans inside the cabin to ventilate out hot air. Hello, welcome to the inside of my tiny home, van. The seats in here are one of two choices. You can either get leatherette, which is really upscale for a van, or tundra fabric, which reminds me of the seats in a GTI with a plaid print. As far as bolstering goes, you know what? That's not bad considering what kind of vehicle this is. Not bad. And also, it has foldable armrests. Ooh, they have clickies in them too. So you could like put that armrest right there, and then it's excellent bolstering because your arm hits it and you won't go anywhere. As far as rear seat leg room goes, it's measured in feet instead of inches. And yes, they're reclinable. This thing has more cubbies and pockets and pouches to shove stuff than I know what to do with. There are tons up here on the dash that look like a great place for change and stuff to just get lost in. What's this? Oh wow, that's not a fold down seat. There's cup holders up here on the dash, which is a terrific idea when you're parked, but I would never want to do that when you're driving. If you were to floor it, you literally will have a can just take off and like shish kebab you in the forehead. Or if you slam on the brakes, it's gonna go down inside your speakers and vents for the HVAC system on top of the dash. That's a terrible idea. Hi. I'm 5'11" and I'm wearing a 4-inch heel. This will give you an indication of what kind of headroom is in here if you would like to stand in the rear of your Metris van. Not really possible. I wore yellow because I was channeling my inner giraffe for this video. Are you LED?
It's not LED, but it does glow on and glow off. Little tiny elements of I'm still a Mercedes, watch me flex. Oh, even this light's got a little soft glow feature to it. That's so cute. That's LED. That is so pretty. The backlight is LED. What about, there's no mirror? Are you joking? Well, I guess people that drive vans don't care about their appearance, maybe. It's a pretty sturdy floor, actually. I like the style and texture of this material. They give you some little D-rings right here that you can tie stuff down with. They're actually all over the place. Nope. This one? Yes, it does. It's a Mercedes. You can tell right there. Thankfully, this doesn't have an electronic parking brake. It's got the old school kind you gotta press with your foot. Let's fire this thing up. Ding. Fries are done. As far as the gauges go, they're very clean and simple analog, and you got a little black and white screen in the center. Has a little cup of coffee on there, which is making me want to go get some. All of the buttons, except for two, in this interior have little pictures of vans. So your dome light, those are vans. And down here on your HVAC, you have a little van doing somersaults. The navigation system on this little itty bitty screen looks like it was designed in Windows 3.1. Basically, it's just an AM FM radio, although it does have Bluetooth, which is good, so you can connect your phone as an audio source. It is not touchscreen. Well, I mean, you can touch the screen and it doesn't look like it's good for it. It looks like you're hitting the earth with little meteors. There's also a keypad so you can phone a friend. Nope, those just turn on different FM stations, which are full of commercials. In the name of science, I am now going to give this van the beans. I'm going to disable traction control, and I'm also going to use the ECM button right here and put it into manual mode. Use these paddle shifters, because why not? Ready? Go. Ooh, actually spun the tires. Go, van. Okay, that's kind of surprising. Good enough. Yo, this van is no slouch. This thing is actually kind of a sleeper.
That's hot. That's why they have
a
yellow thing on it.
Are you a lunchbox or an air cleaner or a top mount intercooler? I'm gonna go with air cleaner. Hello, welcome to Garage Science with Sarah. I apologize for the weird camera angle of the side of the hood. It's the best I could do. This thing does not fit in my garage, but I tried. Anyway, powering the Metris is Mercedes 2-liter turbocharged and direct injected 4-cylinder that produces 208 horsepower at 5,500 RPM and 258 pound-feet of torque at 1,250 RPM. That's not much higher than idle. That is crazy. It makes peak torque that low. It's almost electric-like. Another fun fact, the Metris has an 850 amp hour AGM battery, as well as the alternator will turn off when it is not needed, so it reduces parasitic draw on the engine. Smart. Time for the braking test. No one behind me. Oh, jeez. It turned on the hazard lights. That's a first. These are aggressive brakes. Hello, I'm back. The drivetrain in this Metris has a longitudinal configuration, which means it's rear-wheel drive. Yeah. And if you defeat traction control, you can get this thing a little slideways, allegedly, which is kind of sketchy, allegedly. It has a G-tronic 7-speed automatic transmission, and the paddle shifters in here are actually fairly useful. They do work adequate for a sporty van. Get it, Metris.
get it, Metris. Actually benefits a little bit to short shift in here, because up above 5,000 RPM, not a lot happens, but like between 3,800 and 4,800 RPM is this band's sweet spot. I've been curious since I had this thing to see how it'll handle. I know it's got a high center of gravity. It is a cargo van, but I have a slight suspicion that it probably... It's like, the best way to describe the handling of this thing is it's an excellent handling van. You definitely know you're in a van, but you feel like you can chuck it going into a corner. I mean, yeah, you can feel the body roll, but I bet if you were to upgrade the suspension on here, lower it, and put a wider wheel and tire, it would actually handle fairly decent. Understand why it's so popular right now, because a lot of people don't want to get hundreds of thousands of dollars in debt on a house, especially if you were single. It just doesn't make sense to do that. And you can buy something like this for a fraction of the cost of a home. I personally probably go with the Sprinter because it's got a much higher roof and I'm a Sasquatch. But you can put in here just what you need, and if you work online, you can travel around the globe and explore new places in your home and enjoy driving at the same time. Although I don't think I'd be chucking it around corners if I had some pots and pans swinging in the back. The fuel economy's not bad in it. It has a tight range, actually, from 21 to 24 miles per gallon. And considering how quick this thing is, that's not bad. I like that it's rear wheel drive and not front wheel drive. I like that you can add a bunch of features to it and make this thing luxurious if you wanted to. I think I would just get it stripped down with nothing though and customize it from scratch myself. Either way, I am so glad I reviewed this, and I don't even care if this video gets any views. If you guys never seen one of my car reviews before, I have multiple categories to rate and assess them. Starting with the bean score. It's a rating of 1 to 5 beans based on the feeling you get in your gut when you give it the beans. And this Metris van is getting a rating of 1.1 bean. This thing is actually kind of peppy, and it's probably because there's nothing in it, but it's surprisingly fun to drive. And if you've never driven a van before, and minivans don't count, I'm sorry, you should give it a shot. Next is the cookie score. It is a rating of 1 to 5 cookies based on what you get for what you spend. It's an assessment of value. And this Mercedes Metris 135 van is getting a rating of 2.4 cookies. It's almost $40,000, and considering it's a hollow metal shell with wheels, that's quite a bit of money. But if you think of it as a new home purchase and you plan on converting these into a van life home build, then potentially there's some value there. Lastly is the Penguin score. It was a rating of 1 to 5 penguins based on how much I personally like a vehicle. And this Metris van is getting a rating of 4.1 penguin. I love the idea of creating something from a clean canvas like this van. And van life builds are super interesting. I watch channels that do these all the time. So I like this thing a lot. I just think of all the stuff you can create with it. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you soon with another. Bye.